So you're assisting Mindy.
Yes.
And you made it aware to her, obviously, that you want to write.
Yeah, she knew I wanted to write, yes. And I was writing on the side. And it was a fun year. And then the next year, she promoted me to be writer's assistant.
Oh, okay.
And it was so fun to be in that room. I learned so much. I feel like it was like comedy writing graduate school. Yeah. I was like watching people who really, really knew what they were doing. And it was just so fun. And I had never... It's a hard job, but it's also the only job in the world where like you can laugh so much that you're peeing and you have to like leave the room.
Yeah.
And I was just like, this is great. This makes me really happy. So I was the writer's assistant for 2 years, and then I was a script coordinator, and then I gave her a script of mine, and I was like,
for us of Mindy Project or just no, like original
script, and then she staffed me. So that was like,
that's amazing. So a writer left or something and there was nobody?
No, it wasn't that. I think it was just like, it was my time. Like my script was good. She was going to staff me.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Good for you. I feel like it's really easy to fall in the trap of not writing when you're in a writer's room. Cause you feel like you're actually.
Once I was staffed, I didn't write as much. Cause I also wanted to like work hard in the room and
yeah.
Have to be focused. But yeah, there are also like over those years, the scripts that I wrote, like I wouldn't show them to, you know, it's like I was still finding my voice.
Absolutely.
But I think I probably could have given something to her sooner. Just, I think that like my lesson was that like you have to be confident and you definitely have to show people your stuff. That's a for sure thing. Like you're not a writer if you're just like sitting in your apartment. You have to not showing people, you have to get, and it, like in, you have to get notes, and it's never going to be as scary as you think, but you have to do that. And that's why I say like I wish I had a drop of that like Gen Z like I am entitled to this job thing.
Sure.
Because like I felt so that I wasn't entitled.
Sure.
That I waited too long, and I'm not that I could have gotten a staffing job sooner, but I just think that like you have to like push yourself and show things to people even if you think you're not ready. You know, not like something that's 20 pages and is definitely not ready, but something that's complete. But if like you feel that you're not ready, you got to push through that and just be like, no, I'm ready.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying show it to like the most powerful person you know, but like somebody who's can help you, I think.
Yeah.
I
think that's great insight. I really do.